Hello everyone, thank you for tuning into my channel. So I mentioned on social media and also on Periscope that I've been using the Becca foundation and I was asked to do a review, and because I aim to please, your girl is coming through. This Becca foundation is the ultimate coverage complexion cream and my shade is sandalwood, and then I also have the Becca ever matte poreless priming perfector. Right after I just had Elle, I was invited to Manhattan for a Becca Sephora launch presentation. This was sometime in 2014. Elle was like a couple months old, and I remember taking her with me to the city in my Mobi Wrap, which is a mommy carrying system, and learning a little bit more about Becca and how they have different shades for women of color. And I got to learn a lot of information. So these are not products that I actually went into the store and bought, but I can tell you right now that they are favorites of mine, and they are products that I will be purchasing again because they are good. So with that being said, the Becca Ultimate Coverage Complexion Cream comes in an array of shades from fair skin to, I believe there's one shade darker than me. I love the packaging. I feel like it's really sleek and modern. I like that the top actually isn't clear like some of my favorite foundations, because when there is like residue left in there from the product, you normally can see that on the clear tops. So I actually like that. It has a pump. And I love foundations that have pumps. You don't have to dump them and you don't get excess. When I was at the presentation, Cindy Watson and Kerry Cole talked about how you just need one pump and you're good. And I thought that that was kind of bogus because I've used other foundations that are liquid with pumps. And one pump isn't enough. Not for the coverage that I wanted, at least with my skin tone and the evenness that I expected. But I'm telling you, one pump is enough. When I use one pump along with a dual fiber brush like this, I am able to get an even coat, full coverage all over my face. I don't feel the need to go over to use a second pump at all. And I do like to have a very full coverage look, which for me is great because when I get a foundation, I want to look like I spent a lot of time on my makeup, even though I didn't. I find that the foundation wears really well the entire day. If you're worried about transfer, it does transfer. I also can say that my other favorites, they transfer as well. So transfer is something that I just deal with. I mean, you're putting something on top of your face, it's likely to transfer onto something if you rub too hard. But the product looks great. Pairing it with the Ever Matte Poreless Priming Perfector, hands down a great duo. I've used several different primers and this one is mattifying. It actually says oil absorbing primer that perfects for an all day matte smooth complexion. So if you're someone who is looking for a mattifier, you need to get this. Like, it literally goes on and cakes on. It mattes. It gets so dry, you know, when you put it on, like, whoa, this is really going to make my skin look flawless. And so because it dries really quickly for me, I find it convenient to put dabs on my face versus like rubbing it on something and then trying to smooth it all over, because it really does dry really quickly. So it kind of doesn't disperse really well. So I put dabs and then rub it into the areas that I need it. But all in all, I think that the Becca foundation is really good. I've not picked up my CoverGirl All Day Flawless in over a month because this is a staple of mine right now. I really, really do like it, and I honestly suggest you give it a try. It's in Sephora, and get you some. Let me know if you've ever used this foundation or this primer, what your thoughts were, what you thought about it, and subscribe to my channel. I put out videos every couple of days, and as always, I love you for watching. Bye.